Foster's mind.
The frequent use of symmetry in psychological thrillers constructs a perfect world for the insane characters.
Anything else?
We as an audience are vicariously visualizing the psychopathic character's perception of the world. This video essay focuses on the portrayal of the character's conflicting mind and personality through the visually pleasing symmetry that is composed as part of mise-en-scène. This conveys the implicit meaning that mentally unstable people often situate themselves in an environment of perfection where any sight of imperfections will affect their sanity. A great example is the case of OCD.
It's crooked.
Well, I'm pretty sure you just lost your mind.
Jordan Peele's successful attempt to challenge the norm of horror and thriller conventions is clearly portrayed in the film Get Out, released in 2017. Get Out is a film about an African-American boyfriend, Chris, whose girlfriend Rose invites him for a weekend getaway to meet her family. Wow. But as the weekend progresses, a series of increasingly disturbing discoveries lead him to a truth that he could never have imagined. To further support my claim, I will be comparing four other films, The Grand Budapest Hotel, Split, Shutter Island, and The Danish Girl. Get Out uses mise-en-scène to compose symmetry within its scenes to illustrate the sense of conflict between the personalities of the Armitage through the perfection that we see within the frame. In this scene from Get Out, mise-en-scène is used to create symmetry in Rose's bedroom. For example, we can see that Rose is positioned right in the center of the bed. There are also exactly 10 picture frames on the wall, which associates with completeness, perfection. Identical lamps, curtains, and pillows are also part of this. This creates a calming atmosphere, hence portraying one of her personalities, the emotionless daughter of the psychopathic family, where her other self is Chris's loving and innocent girlfriend. A similar concept of split personalities can be identified in the film Split, released in 2016. Kevin is diagnosed with an extreme case of DID with 23 distinct personalities. The structure here in Hedwig, also known as Kevin's room, also seems symmetrical. The overhead pipes are perfectly aligned, the shelves are identical on both sides, yet his room is still slightly uncoordinated. This represents the chaos of his conflicting personalities.
You've got a crumb on your shirt!
In Get Out, mise-en-scène is used to create symmetry in almost every part of the house. This reinforces the fact that the Armitages are seen as an ordinary family with a seemingly perfect house. It is arguable that this is done on purpose to hide their psychopathic identities. In relation to this concept, Gustav in the Grand Budapest Hotel is shown as arrogant and meticulous in his work. His perception of the world shifts slightly from the ordinary, where everything has to be perfect, in order to keep himself satisfied. His over-exaggerated perfectionist personality is emphasized through the constant use of symmetry throughout the entire film. This implies that unordinary people tend to unconsciously organize their environment to fulfill their satisfactions, to stabilize their mentality and emotions. Like in the film Shutter Island, Teddy Daniels, played by Leonardo DiCaprio, is completely unaware of the fact that he has gone insane from the loss of his wife and children. He constructs a world where he, as a US Marshal, investigates the disappearance of a patient of a hospital for the criminally insane. Teddy is situated within multiple shots of perfect symmetry, like the following scenes. Here he is approaching the symmetry represented by the gate. This foreshadows the fact that he is one of the patients at the hospital, who is uncertain of his real identity, which he then finds out in the end. This supports his conflicting identity between a US Marshal and a patient in the hospital. In The Danish Girl, we first see a perfectly symmetrical face of a female character, Gerda, to illustrate the beauty of femininity. We then start to notice that Ina, Gerda's husband, is often situated in symmetrical environments. Having in mind the association between symmetry and the female beauty supports the conflicting mind of the protagonist, a male who discovers his growing desire to become a female. In conclusion, the elements of the mise-en-scène constructs a perfectly symmetrical space, which contributes to the portrayal of the character's conflicting identity. However, by following the conventions, it can also be said that symmetry used in films are purely for aesthetic purposes.